drawing, I do less of it, and because I've done so much of it already that I feel surer of what I'm doing now after a good 50 years of drawing, and really drawing like crazy. And I do it once in a while, I really do. My father wanted me to learn how to draw for the family business, and he didn't know he was making the biggest mistake in his life. In our father's business, in my father's business, we had some vases that were painted on for the stands, iron stands, and with Amorsolo-like views on each side. And one Sunday I went there, I thought I would be continuing the paintings, and I made such a mess that everybody knew I sneaked in and painted. Medium. Well, there was pencil, yes, pencil. And then we didn't have ball pens or these things that are easy to handle. But I remember now, there was a hardware store that was a mall for us at that period. And that was a smaller thing. In American, it was Parsons Hardware, I remember. And my father's business bought a lot from them. And for Christmas, they had gifts for the family. And they had me and my sister too, to select something, and I selected was a painting box with all kinds of colors and things. You know, I was so overwhelmed, I never used it. I still didn't have a technique to interpret things. It was copying photographs and copying this and that, because they say children are geniuses and this and that. Well, up to a certain point, but the fact is they really construct the painting very badly, or it's really a smashing statement, but not really more. Well, a grown-up person, of course, if he's good at the composition, he's on the right road. The war started when I was 11. So, let's imagine, by then on, we all had to work because we were, everything was taken away from us by the Japanese. And what could we do? We planted camote up in Montalban. Everything was taken away. So we're extremely poor. Really, we're extremely poor. So what things do we have to draw with? It started with this gentleman who came to our house. That was very shortly after liberation. Business was starting again. And he wanted to, hoped to sell some of the, not pseudo Amorsolo, but in the school of Amorsolo. And father didn't like him too much and said no, but would he be kind enough to teach me how to draw? That's how it started. One of the big problems with people who don't know about composition is precisely to compose. Okay, so it's notes thrown in. Imagine a composer just throwing in notes without a composition. The idea that if you learn technique, you have to be a slave of it is ridiculous. You're a slave of it if you have nothing to say, okay? So you have nothing to say, whether it's abstract or it's not abstract, you have nothing to say, because you should be doing something else. Maybe you're a marvelous accountant or a marvelous a fireman or, you know, a bombero now. Pen and ink is a bit more difficult than charcoal. It's more difficult to handle, definitely. But What has influenced me along the what we call dry brush, we'll have some examples here of dry brush painting, is very much inspired by the Chinese or Japanese paintings, definitely. Michelangelo, Da Vinci, Velázquez, Goya, Degas, Toulouse-Lautrec, Van Gogh, Gauguin, the drawings are fabulous, fabulous. So don't give me the baloney that you can just smash around and you know how to draw. No, you don't. I was of a generation that had gone through the war, and we could not pretend that life was beautiful lavanderas and beautiful rice fields and all that. It was no longer that, for us. I must go back to my teacher, who was kind enough, Mr. Celis, was so kind, Alejandro Celis, was so kind that he said one day after months of lessons with him that I should go to the School of Fine Arts because he could not teach me more there alone, and it's good to be with other people of my own age and then with professors like the ones we had in UP.
We were the first batch who transferred to Diliman in 1949. So you would say we were victims, all victims of the war.
He would come as early as the janitor, even earlier sometimes. And then he would paint before classes. And in the late afternoon, he would stay until the building was locked for the night.
Even during our lunch breaks, for example, he would be experimenting on colors, and then we would tease him because he would be scratching and scratching, which is what he's doing until today.
Because he's dedicated to his painting, you could see that he concentrate on his work. He never stopped until he finished his painting. That is just a student, no?
He was the mimic of the class. Huh? He made us laugh. He was jolly, but he was very serious when he started to, you know, when he paints. He really was very conscientious in his painting.
He was not very good in the beginning. And his eyeglasses were this thick. But to show you his love for art, magkasama kami niyan eh. We would stay over time. All the students have gone home, and most of the time, kami dalawa lang. Maybe because we felt we were not very good. So, ang sipag namin. We tried and tried, no matter how unsuccessful our works were. We tried and tried.
He would make a piece of paper, and then little squares of different colors, and then he would be, while he's talking, because he was always talking, we'd be scratching and scratching. And it's the birth of his art.
He has the drive and the intensity. He has both the industry and possibly even at that time vision.
I'm glad that the president gave him an award, you know? And it's a good reaction to the young painters that they are being thought of, and that they are being taken care of by our president, so that people will continuously patronize the Filipino painters. Although he's a foreigner by citizenship, I think, he's still a Filipino painter.
His works are really good, and they really, at least here, they appreciate his work is very much.
I like his colors, and I like the strong lines that he puts into it. And I like him as a person.
I respect him very much. I hold him with high regard for his integrity as an artist. He's also very hardworking, and he came upon the stage where he is now due to hard work.
Not many collectors know about drawings. They stay away from them, I don't know why, because maybe they don't know how difficult and how revealing it is of an artist. At least for those who know drawing and who are used to this type of thing, will see that it is a drawing that is already done by someone who's been drawing for at least 10, 20 years, because this is a freehand thing with no previous drawing at all, and it's a direct thing. So we call this dry brush painting, much inspired, I think, by the Chinese ink paintings. So this is quite hard to master. And of course, at each period, I've changed subjects and technique because I was a different person every 10 years. Like we all do change every 5, 6, 7, 8 years, we are a different person with different experiences. So this was true then. Drawing has that wonderful thing in it that reveals, how can I say, maybe a solo violin or a solo dancer. You know, you cannot be fooling around, pretending. It is there with no adornments, So I've used drawings in many, many, many ways. I've done really thousands of drawings, and some of them, although I never throw anything away, because not that I think they are have any value money-wise, but because then I learn how to not make the same mistakes too often. This was in Binondo. So imagine how Binondo was. Oh, this is an estero, and this is the toilet, the tubo going up. This was the toilet. This was not from nature. This was imagined, okay, it's imaginary. But these were really on the spot. Well, you see, this is Brittany, this is New York, this is Mexico. This is Italy, so you see how I've pursued drawing throughout my life. And now these are all freehand, no previous drawing. And to do perspective like this freehand is crazy. With a brush, it's crazy, absolutely crazy. Well, I went crazy, so that's why I am the way I am, so. Drawing was not terribly respected at that period, really not. You know, it was something to get you going on to better or stronger things. We had to have it. It was part of every day. We had our classes of that. But generally, it was color and paint and this and that. So drawing was something very personal.